dust. Today on Unpacked, we're gonna be talking about prototypes. And here at Fuse Neo, we use prototypes for tons of things, and our clients use them for a lot of different applications. We use them to validate things, to test fit on stuff, to sell an idea, to make decisions faster. Marketers use them to get in the mindset of babies. Brands use them to test with consumers. There's really just a lot of different applications and uses for prototypes. So what are they? How do we make them? What are the different applications? There are two main categories that we put prototypes into. We have the looks like and the works like categories. For the works like categories, here we are maybe testing for fit or doing a line test on something, or we just want to know the size and the scale. How big is this thing when I hold it? Maybe we're testing a little bit about how it goes together and how easy is it to assemble. So there are a number of reasons why we might do just a straight works like prototype, checking dimensions, scale, all that kind of stuff. There are a lot more reasons why we use looks like prototypes, and these are used to sell an idea and to convey a message a lot better. But there are a lot more processes that we use for using looks like models. So looks like models can be used for TV shoots, things like that. They can be used as sales samples. They can just be used to sell an idea up through the brand and show the team what something's going to look like. But let's talk about processes for a minute. There are so many different processes that we might use. Processes like 3D printing, just die cutting. We might use thermoforming, casting, machining. There are a lot of different decoration processes that we might use, from just applying labels to direct printing in different types of print technologies. We might use thermal transfer or pad printing, or there's really just a lot of different ways that we can get to the end result that we need to get to. If we look at some of these looks like samples here, we've got things like this that were thermoformed cup. We actually cast fake yogurt, what we call Thogurt, into this, and then did the labels, the decoration, the overwrap, all of that. We have things like this that were cast to look like a full alcohol bottle in this case. There are things like this, clear SLA, that are just printed to and polished. We have a process that we use for getting these really clear bottles that are polished down to look like a clear bottle. Or again, here where we are trying to get a bottle to look like it has the product inside. Or sometimes even just making fake product, like fake chips. There are processes that are used to get spot gloss and metallic effects. And so there's really just so many different ways that we can get to something. And so what do we need to know when we're building a prototype, and how do we help make a decision on processes that are used? We want to know things like, obviously, what is the item and what are we simulating? But what does it look like? What does it need to look like? Or is it a works like? And what are we trying to simulate? There are cases where we've tried to simulate materials that aren't even in the market yet. How many of them are we going to be making? Who's going to be using it? What's the resolution? What kind of a budget do we have to work in? All of those are factors. So hopefully that gives you at least a little bit of primer on some of the methods and techniques that go into it. We'll probably get into some more detail on specifics in future videos. So stay tuned for those, and subscribe.